Bisphosphonates are usually the first choice for treating osteoporosis.
How do bisphosphonates work?
First, let's quickly review. Osteoclasts break down bone, and osteoblasts build bone. By breaking down old bone and creating new bone, healthy bones are maintained. However, excessive bone breakdown can lead to the development of osteoporosis. Bisphosphonates specifically inhibit osteoclast-mediated bone resorption. Watch this video to learn about the functions of osteoclasts and osteoblasts.
What is the chemical structure of bisphosphonates?
Bisphosphonates are considered analogs of pyrophosphate, allowing them to bind to bone mineral. There are two classes of bisphosphonate compounds, non-nitrogenous and nitrogenous. These two types of bisphosphonates inhibit osteoclasts in different ways.
What is the mechanism of action of bisphosphonates?
Non-nitrogen-containing bisphosphonates are metabolized within the cell into substrates that replace the terminal pyrophosphate group of adenosine triphosphate, ATP, forming a non-functional molecule that competes with ATP in cellular energy metabolism. This process initiates osteoclast apoptosis, leading to a decrease in bone breakdown. Nitrogen-containing bisphosphonates work by inhibiting farnesyl pyrophosphate synthase, an enzyme crucial for the attachment and survival of osteoclasts. By inhibiting this enzyme, nitrogen-containing bisphosphonates prevent the survival and activity of osteoclasts.
What are the notable adverse effects of bisphosphonates?
First, all oral bisphosphonates are associated with upper gastrointestinal adverse effects, including esophagitis and gastritis. Clinicians should avoid prescribing oral bisphosphonates to patients at higher risk of these gastrointestinal issues, such as those unable to sit upright for at least 30 minutes after taking the medication and patients with esophageal disorders.
Second, transient hypocalcemia is a common issue secondary to bisphosphonate use, as inhibiting osteoclasts reduces the release of calcium into the blood. Calcium and vitamin D deficiencies should be corrected before initiating bisphosphonate therapy, particularly with intravenous bisphosphonates.
Third, an atypical femoral fracture is a rare but serious adverse effect of bisphosphonates, typically occurring after more than 7 years of treatment. Initial symptoms include dull aching pain in the groin. If these symptoms appear, an X-ray is necessary for evaluation. Finally, one of the most severe adverse effects is bisphosphonate-related osteonecrosis of the jaw. Most cases of bronch have occurred in patients with multiple myeloma and breast cancer treated with high doses of intravenous bisphosphonates. The risk factors for bronch include pre-existing dental disease. It is recommended to complete any dental treatments before starting the therapy. I will explain these in order.